Last speaker in afternoon section, Tatiana Salnikova. The report is steady states of the Vlasov equation with the Lennard-Jones type potential. Please.
Dear colleagues, good afternoon. Firstly, I'd like to thank the organizers for this very interesting, important, well-organized conference and for the possibility to give here my report, which is devoted to the well-known problem of astrophysics, the stability of galactic models. We have usual question. If we consider a set of a very large number of stars in gravitational interactions, what are the stable statistical distributions over time? In other words, what are the configurations of the observed galaxies in our universe? But how to formulate long-term prediction for a system of 10 in degree 11 bodies, even if we do not know how to satisfactorily solve the three-body problem? And here statistical mechanics come into play. Following the ideas of James Clerk Maxwell and Ludwig Boltzmann, one can try to statistically describe the evolution of n bodies when n tends to infinity using a nonlinear partial differential equation for the phase space probability distribution density. In 1860s and 1870s, this approach was first applied to gas collisions to give the famous Boltzmann equation with Boltzmann collision operator in the right-hand side of the equation. And at the beginning of the 20th century, in between 1910 and 1915, the astrophysicist Sir James Hopwood James supposed that there are practically no collisions between stars and galaxies, and the interaction occurs mainly at a distance through the gravitational field. He used collision-less Boltzmann equation to model stellar clusters and galaxies and to study their stability. This nonlinear transport equation describes the evolution of stellar system on large time scale with excellent accuracy. By the way, in 1937, professor of physical faculty of Moscow State University, Anatoly Vlasov, introduced the same equation in plasma physics, and now we call collision-less Boltzmann equation as Vlasov equation. And the first portrait here is a portrait of British mathematician and chemist Sir John Edward Jenner Jones. He suggested in 1924 some empirical so-called 12-6 potential to describe intermolecular interactions. Potential looks like two terms, repulsion term with sign plus constant divided by distance in degree 12, and with sign minus attraction constant divided by a distance in degree 6. And more general formula, instead of 12 and 6, we can take m greater than n. In our study, we discussed the Vlasov kinetic equation with a modified gravitational potential, a potential of Lennard-Jones type, by adding the potential of repulsive forces to the gravitational potential. It will provide a smooth contact interaction of a system of mutually gravitating particles. Let's consider a system of mutually gravitating particles. Let's consider a system of n mutually gravitating balls, for simplicity, which can repeatedly collide during their motion. And the interaction of particles are of two kinds, attraction because of gravitation and repulsion because of collision. The repulsive forces arise in the process of collisions of particles, and formula will be first formula is for gravitation and the second for our new model. Here we do not specify the physical nature of the force of contact interaction. It is just mathematical model which describe our physical event. The coefficient k here is chosen so that at the distance between the centers of the balls equal to sum of the radii, the forces of attraction and repulsion are balanced. The value of power in denominator, power alpha, may vary, but computer experiments show that the value of alpha weakly affects the qualitative behavior of the system. In this model, due to energy conservation during the movement, the distance between the centers of balls for any pair of balls cannot tend to zero because the quantities of potential should be bounded from above. It means that in this model, for any initial relative velocity, the centers of balls will never coincide. It helps to avoid the singularity, as in gravitational case, and improve the numerical simulations, convergence of numerical simulations. And as for alpha, we will choose it in between 1 and 2, strictly greater than 1 is clear because the power accordingly to Leonard Jones type potential should be greater than another one. It corresponds to 12 and it corresponds to 6 for original suggestion of Leonard Jones. And why less than 2? From classical celestial mechanics, we know for n-body problem that necessary condition for Jacobi stability is not satisfied for a potential which is proportional to distance in degree minus 2. And we will take alpha strictly less than 2. And it turned out later that during our proof of the corresponding theorem, this restriction is principally important. So our subject is to describe the evolution of galaxies with possible collisions. As for observations, there are very nice pictures made by Hubble telescope like this and that. And there are numerical results of John Dubinsky from Canada. Performed by supercomputer on it devoted the evolution of colliding galaxies. It is just a justification why we add collisions to compare with the simplification of genes at the beginning of the 20th century. As for our research, my colleagues, Professor Stepanov and Professor Kudushov and me, considered 2-3 years ago some cosmological problem, and let me stop here. And we have the computer numerical experiments to analyze the interaction of oncoming flows. If we have some two rectangles filled by mass points, which can gravitate and collide, and they start to move to each other, the evolution show us the existence of steady states as compact, let me say, final distribution for this example. And if we start with two parallelepipeds, which are going to each other, we also have compact distribution finally. But what was very interesting that in 30% approximately cases, we obtained two clusters. And it's 71. Two clusters correspond that we can see in galaxies, this percentage of double stars. So It was preliminaries, and our problem setting for this talk is to justify the numerical simulations for our Lennard-Jones potential, and we would like to obtain analytical proof of the existence of the steady states for Lennard-Jones type potential. So we have Vlasov equation with a modified gravitational potential. We have potential functional potential energy like this. It is well known investigation for gravitational potential energy, and we have additional term with sign plus instead of first one here, and we have functional of kinetic energy and energy functional is usually constant along the solutions. And a natural approach to the stability question for a conservative system is to use energy as a Lyapunov function. But in the present case, the energy doesn't have critical points. The energy, the linear path in an expansion about any state, say F0, does not vanish. I'd like to add that to compare with many works on this topic for the gravitational and electromagnetic interaction of the particles described by Vlasov-Poisson equations, here we have no Poisson equation for our modified potential. The phase flow of the equations of characteristics corresponding to the Vlasov equation also preserve the phase volume, and then for any reasonably chosen function phi, the so-called Casimir functional calligraphic C of F is also conserved. Later we will choose the function phi to be strictly convex and with these conditions. To develop the Lyapunov method of studying the nonlinear stability of equilibrium solutions for finite dimensional Hamiltonian systems with additional commuting integrals, Vladimir Ilyich Arnold proposed in 1965 to study instead of Hamiltonian function h plus c, and c is a commuting integral, choosing the Casimir function c so that the function h plus c has a critical point on the stationary solution. By the way, as for equation, differential equation x dot is equal to v of x, where x in Rn. With the first integrals, it is known Rouse theorem that the points of strict local minimum or maximum of one integral at the fixed levels of the remaining integrals determine stationary motions of the system. So these two affirmations were for finite dimensional, and general method for assessing nonlinear stability of fluid and plasma equilibria for infinite dimensional Hamiltonian system was presented in 1985 by this author as Holm, Marsden, Ratiu, and Weinstein in great paper. More than 100 pages, and the energy Casimir method was there written. A rigorous application of this method to Vlasov-Poisson system in various situation is presented in numerous works by Gerhard Rein, and with co-authors, for example, with Jan Go and others. And our research is based at this method, which is written in papers of Gerhard Tein. And the main difficulty was because our new potential is not very nice for this demonstration, this kind of theorems. What is this method about? You can look through. We like to investigate Casimir functionals and to prove the existence of minimizers for functional energy Casimir, HC. And then this minimizer will be steady states, and this solution will be dynamically in Lyapunov sense stable. There are two variational problems. First one is to minimize energy Casimir on the constraint set Fm, where M is prescribed constant. And the second variation problem to minimize energy functional on the constraint set Fm, which is looks like this. And constant M is prescribed parameter, and these two problems differs by the role of Casimir functional. Functional is a part of functional to be minimized, and the second, it is part of the constraint set. We used the second variation problem for our problem under consideration because of absence of Poisson equation. The conserved total energy H contains the terms of opposite signs, and the obvious difficulty is to control the forms of energy separately. It is known technique. It is possible to interpolate the potential energy from the kinetic energy and from the Lebesgue space Lp, and the conservation of each is ensured by the invariance of the Casimir functionals. It means that the potential energy can be controlled by interpolation between the invariance of the system and the kinetic energy with the degree. For gravitational case, it was well known for degree 1/2. It is so-called subcritical case. And for our power alpha strictly less than 2, we also have subcritical case.
For you alpha, have 2 minutes rest.
Excuse me?
2 minutes rest.
I
minute осталось.
Okay. So we can formulate the corresponding theorem on the existence of minimizer. The proof of this theorem follows the steps, which is well known for gravitational case, but we have some additional problem because of presence of additional term, positive term, part of kinetic or part of potential energy. And then this, as a result, this theorem was proved. It let us affirmate dynamical stability. And thank you for your attention.
Thank you.
Maybe I'll show bibliography.
Okay. Questions, please. Questions, remarks.
Very interesting.
Thank you.
Am I right that the minimizer is unique here?
Yeah. I didn't catch.
Is the minimizer unique? Единственный ли минимизер? Или может быть несколько?
In our setting, it's the only minimizer for our restricted, for our parameters.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. More questions, please. Remarks? No, thanks, speaker again.
Thank you.
And,